Hi, good afternoon everyone. My name's Aiden Sydenham. I'm science technician with DAF up in Queensland. I'm just here to give you a chat about a project we've run for the last 2 years out looking at enhancing feral pig monitoring and control in the Western Downs of Queensland. So here's a bit of a map showing our project site we're working on. So it's primarily a cattle property that runs a little bit of cropping around in here for supplementary cattle feed. The property is roughly about 40,000 hectares, so it's a fair size, but from what I've heard from a lot of the other sites that have been getting around, not too big in comparison. The actual entire property is enclosed with exclusion fencing, which was finished off in midway through 2023, which might be a bit important later on when we get to it. But I'll just draw your attention to this corner here is where majority of the actual work was undertaken for this project. So we had six components to this project. So we did some aerials. We did aerial surveying across the 2 years. We did one trial with the thermally assisted aerial surveying. We did some camera monitoring, GPS collaring, ear tagging, aerial culling, and some opportunistic pathogen sampling towards the end of the project. So this is a camera grid which I've now noticed that we've seen about four or five times today. So I won't spend too much time explaining it, but we had 60 cameras on a 1 kilometre hexagonal grid that Andy Bengtson helped us set up, so thank you to him. So that camera grid was first deployed in April 2022, and I've spent every 5 weeks since then going out changing camera batteries and SD cards in each one of those cameras. Interestingly enough, only two of those cameras haven't seen a pig. So this camera here and this camera up here are the only two that haven't seen a pig in that time. Here are just some results we've got from the camera grid. As you can see, in 2022, we detected a total of 1,026 pig groups, which summed up to be about just under 2,200 pigs within that camera grid. We moved down into 2023 and we can see it's dropped, the number of groups dropped about half, but the sum of groups dropped significantly. And these are the results so far from 2024. I know we're only about halfway through, but as you can see, we've dropped significantly again. Right. Aerial surveys. So we've done five surveys across the last 2 years. This out here, it's not a very great map, but I didn't draw this one, so I'm not taking the blame for it. This red line for all the colorblind people, like myself, it's very hard to see. And this is just where our camera grid is in comparison to where the blue transects have been flown. And then we move on to the next thing. As I explained a bit before, we were doing a bit of mark recapture stuff within our camera grid. So over the 2 years, I spent a fair bit of time trapping pigs and putting some collars and some ear tags in those animals. So these are our 12 trap sites that we had for the across the 2 years, because we really wanted to have try and get as many animals within that camera grid as possible. We spent a fair bit of time trying to get those animals. In total, we ended up having 24 pigs collared across the 2 years. As you can see here, a fair chunk of those were collared for less than 12 months because one particular station hand liked to go and chase them and shoot them. So that was fun. The biggest pig that we had collared was a 100 kilo boar, and then everything fell in between that and a 40 kilo boar. I've lost my place. The next thing I've got is just a bit of a screenshot of the collaring data that we had from the project. So as you can see, this is about the extent of where that camera grid was. So we had a fairly amount of all the pigs wanting to stay within the camera grid, which was very good, except for three or four that found some protein lick that one of the commodities was housing. So they decided they wanted to stay there for the entirety of the time they were collared. Another important pig here is this red pig here. So he started his journey, he got collared here and lived in within the camera grid for a while. And then he actually slipped out underneath the exclusion fence and stayed out here for a few months. And then he ended up finding his way back through the fence and then remained up into that that project area and was actually shot just here about a year later. Another interesting pig we had was pig 531. He started the project as an ear-tagged pig. He weighed about 30 kilos. In about halfway through 2022, a couple of months later, we actually caught him again when we were trying to put some collars out, and he had put on about 15 kilos. So we decided to whack a collar on him and let him go. Then after that, he evaded three other culling events, and we finally got him the last one, and he weighed about 64 kilos. So that showed he put about 34 kilos on across 600 days, which was quite interesting to have as part of the project. That does lead me into our aerial culling component. So we had six different shoots across 2 years. We tried to line those up as best we could with our aerial surveys to get the most out of those. And we ended up shooting just about 5,000 pigs out of those six shoots. As you can see here, these blue lines are the actual results from the aerial surveys showing the estimated pig densities, and red lines are how many pigs were removed during those cull events. As part of the two of the last culling events, we did some opportunistic pathogen sampling for a PhD student down in Sydney. So we collected about 30 samples from a variety. We had 15 boars and 15 sows. Interestingly enough, half these samples had JEV antibodies present with actually no active JEV found in the samples. One pig turned a positive sample back for Brucella, and 70% of the samples turned back a positive for leptospirosis. So I suppose this is the getting towards the end of my presentation here. I've gone through and explained all the different components we had, but I just wanted to highlight the actual time it took to deliver those components, because there's not much point in me telling you how much money we spent versus, because everyone here knows what it takes to run their team and like what it costs to, you know, have your choppers up in the air and your shooters. So I just wanted to highlight what the actual effort took. So if you're looking to plan something similar, that you know roughly what you're in for. So the final part is the overall change in experiences. What did we find out of all of this effort? So this graph here shows the total number of pig detections per month for the camera grid, alongside with the numbers culled out of that site. As you can see, quite a significant drop across the number of pig detections. And it was actually quite interesting to be there, because when we started there, putting out all those camera grids, we could see 100, 200 pigs a day just driving around. But now, once you go out there, you're lucky to see a pig for the 2 days that you're driving around. So it was quite surprising to see that and actually be a part of it. Pretty proud to be a part of that project where we got to be involved with all these different stakeholders up here that made it possible. Thank you.